You cannot say yes to God and yes to fear at the same time. It forces you to say no to one of them. And as long as you are saying yes to fear, you are saying no to God. Money causes people to say no to God when the spirit of mammon in fear come on your money. Luke 16, 13, no servant can serve two masters. Either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will hold the one and despise the other. Ye cannot serve God and mammon. Maybe your translation says money, but the Greek says mammon, because mammon is not money. Mammon is when the spirit of fear comes on your money. It's when you are afraid of your money running out before it runs out. It's when you prioritize money over God. And here's the problem. Money will cause people to say no to God. They did it in the Bible. It's happening today, and it will happen tomorrow. Let me show you Luke chapter 18. Luke chapter 18, verse 18, it's a story of a rich young ruler. And it says this in verse 18, and the rich man asked God, good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus said to him, why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. You know the commandments, do not commit adultery, do not murder, do not steal, do not bear false witness, honor your father and mother. And he said, all of these things I have kept from my youth. When Jesus heard this, he said to him, one thing you still lack. Sell all that you have and distribute it to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Come and follow me. Verse 23, but when he heard these things, he became very sad, or his face fell. For he was extremely rich or had great possessions. Jesus, seeing that he had become sad, said, how difficult it is for those with great wealth to enter the kingdom of heaven. Let's exegete this text. It's important to have sound doctrine, that you do not apply one scripture to one person and apply it to everybody. Jesus did not tell the man with the withered hand to sell all that he had. He did not say to the woman caught in adultery, sell all that you have and give it to the poor. He told the woman who was caught in adultery to go and sin no more. So Jesus was dealing with a man who had a money problem. And he was a rich man. And as he's encountering Jesus and saying, what do I need to be saved? What do I need to encounter the kingdom of God? He begins to teach him. And he said, I do all those things. That's great. And then Jesus discerns this guy's got a money problem. So he says, I want you to sell all that you have. And he said, I can't do that. And the Bible says that he went away sad, or his face fell. Literally, this is only used one other time in scriptures with his face falling, and it's actually used as when clouds rise or fall, or his entire countenance fell, watch, because he said no to Jesus. Hold on a second. Just imagine this. You are talking to Jesus in the flesh, and you say no to Jesus in the flesh over money. And there's a lot of people that are like, oh, I would never be able to do that, yet we do all the time. When God speaks to us to do something and our response isn't yes, our response is no. Many people say no to God over money. Do you know what's why Judas betrayed him for 30 pieces of silver? We betray him by not tithing. We say no to God when he tells us to give something or do something, and we tell him no. Do you realize how deep this is? This is so deep in the hearts of man. This is why over and over Jesus taught on money, because it's where your heart is. And it's so deep, watch, it will affect people's eternity. I'm gonna show you. Because according to scripture, the Antichrist will use money to get people to say no to God. You ready for this? Revelation chapter 16. It says this, sorry, Revelation 13, verse 16. Also, it will cause both small and great, rich and poor, both free and slave, to be marked on the right hand of the forehead, so that no one can buy, sell, unless he has the mark. That is the name of the beast, or the number of his name. This is wild. I want you to look at this. It will cause both small and great, rich and poor, both free and slave. Watch. See, this has nothing to do with how much money you have. It's a heart issue. And according to scripture, the Antichrist will get people to say no to God because their money won't work unless they have the mark of the beast. Are you hearing this today? The Antichrist will get people to say no to eternity with God because of their love of money. Now, majority of people here are probably like Peter. You're like, I would never do that. I would never get a mark. I would never, Peter say, I would never betray you, Lord, ever. No matter what, everyone would betray you and not me with a rooster's about to crow. Because I'm going to help you right now. How would you know if you are susceptible to the mark of the beast? How are you susceptible to know if you would be the one that would give in to the pressure and say no to God? Let me tell you, it's those that say no to God now over money. And if you're saying no to God now over money, it is a matter of time that you say no to him for eternity. That is how deep this goes.